All right, good morning. Today we shall be learning under the course Internet Computing. We'll be looking at the lecture topic IP addresses. Once again, my name is Adekoya Lawrence. I am your lecturer in this course, and you can always find me on the YouTube channel. The link is displayed right now on the screen, and you can also find me on Facebook, and of course I am on Twitter, and you can tweet at me at the Twitter handle at below 1245. Alright, so what is an IP address? What is an IP address? Quick one, an IP address is an identifier of a computer over the network. An IP address is an identifier of a computer on a network. Now, let me quickly explain that there are millions of devices on the internet as the global network presently. And of course, remember the internet runs the TCP IP protocol. So whatever network is running in the TCP IP protocol, requires that every device on such a network should have what we call the IP address, an internet protocol address. So this address serves as the identifier of every device on such a network. Yes, that is what an IP address is. For instance, your mobile phone, and of course whatever device you are using to connect to the internet presently, or onto any network for that matter, be it a local area network or a public network or a private network, there is a need for what we call the IP address in order for such a device to be identified on the network. Alright, so what does an IP address contain? IP addresses contain vital information about the network, and some of the key things they contain is, first of all, the network address. So every IP address contains two parts mainly. The first part is the network ID, and of course the second part is the host ID, meaning that like a typical home address that we have in any part of the world, you will discover that in the home address, the first part of the address, the first thing in the address is to write the house number followed by the location of the house, which includes the street, the region, the state, and of course the country. And that represents the network address. Now the house address represents what we call the host address. While the location, the geographical location of a physical house, for example, we can say that a place probably in Victoria Island, Lagos, can be addressed as, first you mentioned the house address, which is the host ID, the house number, which is the host ID on the IP address. Say, house number 20, Akin Olubade Street. Now you are beginning to describe where can we locate the particular house number 20, Victoria Island, Lagos, Nigeria. So that part represents the network address. So in an IP address, what an IP address actually tells us is, first of all, how do we locate which network does the host to receive the information reside. So the host net, the network address tells us we are to locate the host. Then when we get to that network, then we are going to have to identify the host itself, and that is the host ID. So now there are types of IP addresses. There are types of IP addresses, and I can tell you that there are two major types. The first type is what we call the IP version 4. The IP version 4. The IP version 4 is the first type of IP addresses, and we use the two major formats to represent what we call the IP version 4 address. The IP version 4 address is a 32-bit address, a 32-bit binary address. So you can see it right here on the screen. You can see it, a 32-bit IP address means it's a group of four groups of 8 bits. So we call them the octets, a group of four octets. So the first part, like for example the one displayed on the screen right now, 11000000, it's 8 bits long. That is the first part, the first octet on of the IP address. The next second octet is 10101000. That is the second octet. And of course the third octet 00000001. And of course the fourth octet 10011000. And that is what the computer sees your net, the IP address of your device on the network actually is. But since it is difficult for human beings to memorize or to remember this kind of long binary digits, the decimal version was created, and this decimal version is known as the dotted decimal. Now, the dotted decimal is easier for humans to remember, and that is why it was developed. So it is four decimal numbers separated by full stops or by dots, and that is why it is called the dotted decimal. So the same IP address 100, all these long bits of a stream of binary digits, is still the same thing as is what humans see, 192.168.1.152. That is an example of IP version 4. And it is easy for us to convert these long stream of binary digits into decimal, memorable decimal number in the dotted decimal. For example, when you want to convert, this thing is very easy. You can simply have a table like this, and then from the right down towards the left, you can see in the blue version, in the blue region, you can see decimal numbers from beginning from one, and then you begin to double them towards the right. And then you continue to double them like that. For example, here we have one. When you double one, you have two. When you double two, you have four. 8, 16 is the double of 8, and 32 is the double of 16, then 64, and of course 128. Because we have just 8 bits in the IP address, we only need 8. So between 1 to 128 is sufficient for us to convert each of the octets of an IP address into decimal. Then when we have this table like this, all we need to do is to enter our binary number from left to right, and then sum up only the numbers above the one digit. The one digit, for example, here in this number 11000000, only 128 and 64 has one under them, and then we're going to have to sum those two numbers together, and then whatever we get becomes the decimal version of this binary digit. And for example, you have here, you have 128 plus 64 to give us 192. That's why we have 192 here. So for you to convert, the second octet is the same manner, so you just have to continue doing it that way, and then you will have your 192.168.1.0.152. That is IP version 4. So the next type of address, the second part, the second one, is the IP version 6. The IP version 6. Now the reason we have IP version 6 is because we are running out of IP version 4 possible addresses. We are running out of them, and so the version 6 was created in order to fill in the gap. Some devices are already using version 6, while some are still using many are still using version 4, and I tell you, version 4 will still be around for a long time. Version 6 is only here to come back. An example of IP version 6 address is something like this. You can see it is hexadecimal in nature, and it's very much longer. It contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 parts. And then it is a 128 bit long address. So it is each part of this IP address, for example 2001, is also a group of 16. It's a group of 16, it's hexadecimal in nature, and then you can understand that 16 multiplied by 8 will give us 128 bits long. So but we're not going to be focusing on IP version 6, we're going to be focusing on IP version 4. And of course, IP version 4 has classes of addresses. It has classes of addresses. So what are the classes of IP version 4? Of course, we have 5 different classes in the IP version 4. You have the class A, class B, class C, class D, and class E. The class A IP version 4 is the first octet of the class A address is between the range 0 to 127, and of course every class B address begins from 128 to 191. In the first octet, the first value must begin from this range. For any number, any IP address you see that begins from 0 or that begins from 1 is a class A address, or that begins from 127 is a class A address. Any IP address you see that begins from 128 to 191 is a class B address. Any address that begins from 192, for example the one we saw in our previous example, this for example is 192.168.1.152 is a class C IP address. It's a class C IP address. So class D IP address begins from 224 to 239, and then class E is from 240 to 255. So the first octet ranges from 0 to 255 IP numbers for the version 4 IP address. So those are the classes of version 4 IP addresses. Now, how do we identify the class of an IP address? Of an IP address, I'm referring to the version 4 IP address. How do we identify the class? Because it is important for us to be able to identify the class of each and every address we come across, and that will enable us to understand the address better and understand the use of it, and of course the location, the network upon which the address or the host is located. So how do we identify that? Let us look at these addresses. 10.50.120.7. The first way to identify this is to look at the first octet. Remember the range I gave you from 0 to 128 is a class A address, and then of course we have 172 to 172.16.55.13. Because 172 lies within the range of the class B address, we say this is a class B address. And of course we have been trying to identify these IP addresses by understanding or knowing, remembering the range of the first octet, the range of the first octet. And of course again we have another one, 192.16.168.17.43, and this, because it is 192 now, it is a class C IP version 4 address. But how did we know these? Of course, one way to know this is to look at the first octet. And another way to know this is what we call the subnet mask. So what is a subnet mask? The subnet mask is a number that defines the range of IP addresses available within a network. It defines the range of IP addresses available within the network. And of course, the subnet mask enables us to identify the network ID and of course the host ID, the network path and the host path within an IP address. This is an example of the dotted decimal of the subnet mask. 255.255.255.0 is what we call the subnet mask, the dotted decimal version. Of course, the binary version of the subnet mask is a stream of ones followed by a stream of 0 bits. A stream of 1 bit followed by a stream of 0 bits. And for example, if you understand the conversion pattern that I taught before in the table, if you convert these, if all the bits under the decimal numbers were to be all ones, what you will get, the decimal number you will get is 255. And if all the bits under the decimal are all streams of zeros, what you will get is zeros. So all this one is 1111111, that represent 255, 1111111, that represent 255, and then of course followed by zeros that represent the zero path. So this is an example of the dotted decimal of IP of the subnet mask. So in identifying the IP address, of course, the subnet mask tells us what part is the network part and what part is the host part. For example, in this particular one, this 255.255.255.0 tells us that the first 24 bit is used for network, while the last 8 bit is used for is used for the host part. Okay, so after that, we look at some other examples of the subnets. For example, you look at this, we have this binary, this IP address, 8.20.15.1 is an IP address. This is the dotted decimal version, and of course, this is the binary IP address. Now, the subnet mask is 255.0.0.0, and that means that the first 8 bits, only the first 8 bits are used for network, while the last 24 bits are used for host part. So the zero stream of zero represents the host part, while the stream of ones represents the network part. Another example is this 192.168.1.0, and this is the subnet. And the subnet is represented in these binary version. You can see that the first three octets, that is the first 24 bits, are used for the network, while the last 8 are used for the host. And that is where you have the 255.255.255. So when to identify this using subnet mask, in the class A IP address, in the class A IP address, you discover that only the first octet of the subnet is used for network, and there's a change in bits from 0 to 1 represents the demarcation between network part and the host part. So in this one, you can see the demarcation is on the first octet, and that is why it is known as a class A IP address. On this other one, you can see that the demarcation is on the third octet, and that is why it is known as the class C IP address. So that is just simply the way to use subnet mask to identify the type of network or the class of an IP version 4 network. Now, subnets can also help us to subdivide a particular network into another group of smaller manageable network, and that's what we call subnetting. But that is not within the range or the view of this lecture series. So that is IP addresses in brief, and of course we have been able to look at the definition of IP addresses, we have been able to look at the classes of IP addresses, we've seen what we call the decimal version, and of course the dotted decimal, and of course the binary part version of IP addresses, the classes, and of course we've seen what subnet is. And thank you for listening, and that is the simple lecture for today. We'll see again next time to take it again from to the next level. God bless you. Don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to drop an encouraging comment. Don't forget to share. And most importantly, if you are new on this video channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thank you very much. God bless you.